In this video, I shall demonstrate some superficial reflexes which form a part of the normal CNS motor system examination. We know that a reflex is an automatic response to a stimulus and it does not need any conscious thought. The spinal reflex are mediated via a reflex arc. Now this reflex arc consists of an afferent neuron, an interneuron and an efferent neuron. Abdominal and cremastic reflexes are absent in both upper and lower motor neuron lesions, while plantars are upgoing in upper motor neuron lesions. But the importance of superficial reflexes that significantly asymmetrical response does help in clinically diagnosing the site of lesion or the laterality of the lesion. So the commonly elicited superficial reflexes are conjunctival, corneal, pharyngeal, abdominal and plantar. But there are some other superficial reflexes as well, which we shall see later. Now, corneal and conjunctival reflexes both are elicited in the same manner. They have the same afferent and the same efferent. So, to elicit them, first thing, you ask the patient to look to the opposite side so that you may avoid the menace reflex. Now, you touch the conjunctiva or cornea from behind with the help of a cotton wick. The response consists of reflex blinking of the eyes because of contraction of the orbicularis oculi muscle, which is supplied by the 7th cranial nerve. So we see that the afferent is the ophthalmic division of the cranial nerve 5, that is 5-1, and the efferent is the facial nerve. Now we'll see how. Similarly, to elicit the abdominal reflex, stroke the abdominal skin in all the four quadrants from without inwards. The response will be a contraction of the skin as we stroke a particular quadrant. This checks for integrity of the spinal segments T6 to T12. The epigastric checks T6 to T8, upper abdominal T8 to T10 and the lower abdominal T10 to T12. The cremastic reflex is elicited by stroking the inner part of the upper thigh and the response is ipsilateral pull of the testis and the scrotum. It checks for integrity of the L1, L2 spinal segment. See how. And the plantar reflex is elicited by stroking the lateral border of the foot up from the heel to the base of the great toe. Now, if you want to know the details of eliciting the Babinski sign or extensor plantar reflex, please refer to another video, the link of which I have shared in the description box below. We'll see how. You can see the child is doing gymnastics maneuver by pulling his fisted fingers apart. This helps in eliciting the sign easily. Other superficial reflexes are pharyngeal reflex, also commonly referred to as the gag reflex. We know the afferent and efferent are cranial nerves, afferent being 9th and efferent being the 10th cranial nerve. Now there is one scapular reflex not commonly asked by the examiners to demonstrate, but you must know because it checks the integrity of the cervical spinal cord segment C4 to C5 and it is elicited by stroking the interscapular skin, which leads to contraction of the scapular muscles. The afferent is C4-5 and efferent is the dorsal scapular nerve. Similarly, bulbocavernosus reflex checks the integrity of sacral segments 3 and 4 and it is the contraction of the internal or external anal sphincter on squeezing the glands or tugging in on an indwelling Foley's catheter. Anal reflex, also referred to as perianal reflex or anal wing, checks for integrity of the sacral segments S4 and 5 and it comprises of external anal sphincter contraction on stroking the skin around the anus. So, while superficial reflex means stimulating a superficial surface of the body, for example, the skin or superficial mucosa in case of corneal, conjunctival and pharyngeal reflexes. But the deep tendon reflexes are known as deep because they are elicited by stroking the deeper structures, that is the muscle tendons. The superficial reflexes are polysynaptic, that is the sensory signal has to first reach the spinal cord, then ascend to the brain, then back to the spinal cord to reach the motor neurons. On the other hand, the deep tendon reflexes are monosynaptic. It is important to remember that while both these reflexes check for the integrity of the CNS pathways, the superficial reflexes are lost in the upper motor neuron lesion because of interruption of the descending pathways, which also form a part of the polysynaptic reflex. On the other hand, the deep tendon reflexes are exaggerated in upper motor neuron lesions, while in lower motor neuron lesions, both superficial as well as deep tendon reflexes, they are lost. Thank you for watching patiently and have a good day.